Hello, my name is Recky. Welcome back to another reaction. We're going to take a look at some sports today, and particularly when it comes to baseball. I don't know a lot about baseball, but it's one of those sports where the game lasts forever, which is very uncommon here in Sweden. Used to be a fan of the New York Mets. I have an authentic jersey. What I bought when I was in New York. So that's pretty cool. Right? Smack the like, and of course hit that subscribe if you enjoy. The video we're going to watch is the dumbest things that have ever happened in baseball. Let's go some sports. Let's do some sports, Recky. Thank you so much to the channel members and the patrons. Thank you so much. Amazing support. A big shout out to the Supreme Tier donators over by Patreon and of course on channel membership. Personal shout outs to the ultimate supporters, Deja, Walt, Tammy, Roni, and Wayne. I salute you. Now, let's do some baseball. Baseball!
In baseball, there's a ton of ways to mess up. But did you know that somebody actually messed up so bad they had to evacuate the Capitol building?
No.
And that's not even close to the dumbest thing that has ever happened on a baseball field. These mistakes have lost teams games, may have cost a team a World Series, caused actual riots, gotten games canceled, and have even led to people being arrested. But most of the time, these mistakes just result in people booing and laughing. Like when Milton Bradley got a fly ball in the eighth inning with one out.
And Bradley plays it off to the side, and he doesn't know how many outs there are. He just throws the ball into
the... Bradley threw the ball into the stands with only two outs, allowing one run to score and another to go to...
Oh, he didn't know that was runners out of...
Third. This happens more than you would think. Like when Anthony Gose made a running catch, and for some reason, just kept on running. The runner scored from second, and he felt extremely dumb. Usually, this just causes players to look dumb for a second, realize they messed up, then laugh at themselves.
Yeah, move along.
With zero consequences. Sometimes, it actually screws a team over. Like when Benny Agbayani made this play while winning 1-0. The Giants tied the game on a sack fly, but Benny thought there were three outs, gave the ball to a kid, realized there were only two outs, took the ball away from the kid, but it was too late. The Giants scored, and we're now winning 2-1. When a player makes a stupid mistake that cost a team a game, people are pissed. When the grounds crew makes a stupid mistake that cost a team a game, there's a good chance they're all gonna get fired. That's what happened to the Marlins, who during their first season ever made the extremely stupid decision to hire employees by going to a local high school and hiring high schoolers to be in charge of the tarp. This is according to one of the members of the crew, who says that this was the first time they had ever had to put the tarp out during a game, and for some reason, rolled it out into the outfield. They started dragging it all the way into the infield, but the tarp got stuck, so the grounds crew had to start over. They tried to drag it out again, but it got stuck again. They tried it again with even more speed. It got stuck again. They tried for a third time with even more speed, and it got stuck again. It got so bad, the Marlins manager came out to help them. They tried another attempt with even more people and got stuck again. It got so bad, the Marlins manager quit trying to help them. The grounds crew tried a new strategy by moving the tarp all the way to left field. They tried again, succeeded, but only covered half of the infield.
So the tarp is supposed to only cover up the infield and not the outfield. To my knowledge, you gotta correct me if I'm wrong.
But finally, after six attempts in over 20 minutes, they were able to drag the tarp onto the infield. Unfortunately, at this point, the rain had already stopped and the field was covered in water. What should have been a 20-minute delay led to an hour and a half delay. And after the game, the entire grounds crew of high school kids was fired. Troubles with the tarp are bound to happen during extreme weather, like when the Pirates grounds crew got the tarp stuck and literally had a member of the team swallowed by it. he had to be saved by the Pirates players, who ended up having to become the grounds crew and hold down the tarp in pouring rain. This grounds crew member got swallowed by the tarp, nobody realized it, and had to crawl out while fighting for his life. In 2014, the Yankees grounds crew messed up so bad, the field was soaked to the point where they had to cancel the game in the fifth inning. But since the Yankees were winning by a run at the time, the grounds crew messing up actually got them the win. In 2018, the Phillies grounds crew forgot to put the tarp out overnight. It rained, the field was soaked, they tried to use a flamethrower to try to dry it out, that didn't work, and the game was canceled.
A flamethrower?
Even though the weather was fine. Which begs the question, why don't they just invent a tarp that rolls itself, eliminating the need for grounds crew members and unnecessary delays? Actually, they had this in the 80s, and it almost ended a player's career. Vince Coleman was Rookie of the Year and led the league in stolen bases. The Cardinals were relying on him heavily during their run to the World Series. But in Game 4 of the NLCS, he and his teammates were hanging out on the field before the game, when for some reason, the automatic tarp started rolling out on the field. Coleman had his back turned, and the metal tube that weighed a half ton crushed him and fractured his leg, ending his season before the most important series of his career. Automatic tarps have pretty much gone extinct ever since, while the number of stadium employees have gone up and up. They usually do a great job. But not always. Like in New York, when the grounds crew made the sprinkler system go off in the middle of a game. In Arizona.
But that's automatic. Right? It's definitely the groundskeeper.
JJ Putz was about to throw a pitch when the sound guy accidentally pressed a button which played the most random sound ever heard. Bat boys are constantly making some of the most amazing plays while also making some of the worst plays ever. But this one made the worst mistake a bat boy can by catching a ball and throwing it into the stands even though it was fair. A few moments later, another ball came to him. It was foul, but he was so scared of messing up again, he just stayed completely still.
Yeah, I would do the same. I wouldn't move.
Perhaps the stupidest decision surrounding Bat Boys is the Giants, who insist on hiring senior citizens to do it. On one hand, this is a great gesture. It was originally part of their senior involvement program, giving older people a chance to get involved and do something they otherwise would never get to do. Hundreds of elderly ball boys apply every year, and dozens are picked to attend a ball dude tryout, where they practice catching grounders, pop flies, and answer trivia questions. The Giants then pick the best elderly ball dudes and dudettes to do it in real games. The problem is, this has led to a ton of falling, face planting, extremely long delays as they try to travel long distances, and probably creates an opportunity for serious injury. But it may also be the best and coolest stupid idea in baseball history.
I like it, but it's one of those times when you shouldn't laugh.
Other stupid ideas.
Don't laugh, Recky. Do not laugh.
Sounded cool at first, but ended up being so stupid, it might have actually cost a team a game. During the 2010 World Cup, the Marlins...
Was that the Vuvuzelas World Championship in soccer or football? That was the same thing. There was like a 200 people just blowing this Vuvuzelas, so you couldn't even focus on the game.
Marlins did a Vuvuzela giveaway. The same horn that blared throughout the tournament in South Africa was given to 15,000 fans who showed up to a Florida Marlins game. The stadium was maybe a third full, but the horns were so loud and annoying, players put in earplugs. Umpires put in earplugs.
Yeah,
and according to Dan
Ugla,
it was the worst promotion he's ever been a part of. In the bottom of the ninth, in a tie game, Brian Barden got a leadoff walk, but the umpire realized he wasn't supposed to be hitting. Apparently, the Marlins made a substitution that put Brian Barden in the ninth spot in the order. They told the umpire he was batting ninth, but for some reason, the umpire put him in the third spot in the order. Even though the Marlins clearly put him in the ninth spot, the umpire card, which said he was supposed to bat third, is official, so when he batted ninth like he was supposed to, he was automatically out. And there's a very good chance the loud vuvuzelas led to this miscommunication. What represented the winning run was now automatically out. The Marlins didn't score, and in the...
I hated those. It was so bad, I turned off the sound on the TV and actually listened to the radio commentators because it was unbearable. Let me know if you actually was around the time when vuvuzelas was a thing. I hate those.
11th, with the vuvuzelas still going, the Rays scored 4 and won the game. Afterwards, the Marlins still deemed this promotion as a success. And compared to these other promotions, it was. For example, in 1997, the Charleston River Dogs did a free vasectomy night, a promotion that allowed any adult who bought a ticket the opportunity to enter a raffle. The winner of this raffle won a free surgery that made it so they could no longer have kids. Unfortunately, many people, including the Roman Catholic Diocese of Charleston, complained and the promotion was canceled.
That's the dumbest thing I ever heard.
As bad as this was, the Dodgers once did a promotion so dumb, they had to forfeit the game. They gave away 53,000 toy baseballs. This seemed like a good idea until a couple bad calls happened and people started throwing the baseballs onto the field. After a delay to clean up the balls, there were more questionable calls and 2 ejections. So Dodgers fans threw thousands of toy baseballs onto the field. The umpires decided the game could not go.
But don't give fans anything to throw in. Don't do it.
One, so the Dodgers had to forfeit because they gave away 53,000 toy baseballs. The Red Sox once did a promotion that seemed even more innocent when they gave away free posters of their closer, Derek Lowe. The problem was, Red Sox fans were not Derek Lowe fans. He ended up blowing a save on his own poster night. So as he was being taken out of the game, fans started throwing the Derek Lowe posters onto the field, causing a 15-minute delay. But this is nothing compared to what the Nationals did, which was so dumb, they actually had to evacuate the Capitol building. But before we get to that, a quick word from today's sponsor. Raycon has the most affordable and reliable earbuds I've ever used. I've been wearing them for months while exercising and they're perfect. They stay in your ear, they don't break when they get sweat in them, and the battery life is amazing. These things have 8 hours of playtime, which is more than enough. Unlike other earbuds I've used, I have yet to run out of battery when I need them. They're also extremely affordable. At half the price of other earbuds, you can get the same quality. So whether you keep losing your earbuds and hate having to pay hundreds of dollars to replace them, you just need a backup pair for when your other earbuds run out of battery, or you just want the same quality earbuds for half the price, Raycon is your best bet. Especially now, they're offering 2 years of product protection insurance for only a few bucks. They have free and easy return guarantees, and right now, they're offering 15% off to anyone who clicks the link in the description box or go to buyraycon.com/baseballdozen. This is a great deal and an amazing way to support the channel. So click the link below and buy Raycon right now. Every year on opening day, teams do opening day ceremonies. This year, the Brewers did a flyover with fighter jets. Unfortunately for the fans, they didn't see it because for some reason, the Brewers did a flyover with the roof closed. The Nationals did something even worse. In 2022, they had service members jump out of a plane and parachute onto the field for Military Appreciation Night. The problem was, they never properly communicated this to the Capitol Police.
Oh!
Who tracked the aircraft on their radars, couldn't identify it, and sent a message to Capitol staffers that they identified an aircraft that caused a, quote, probable threat to the U.S. Capitol building. The building was evacuated before they quickly realized it was just the Nationals. Luckily, this did not affect anything that happened on the field. But that can't be said for the White Sox, who made a uniform decision that was so dumb, it caused a player to cut up his teammates' uniforms with scissors 40 years later. In 1976, as a funny publicity stunt, the White Sox became the only MLB team to wear shorts during a game. During this game, they set their season high with 5 stolen bases. They won the game, had a massive increase in attendance, and believe it or not, the players actually seemed to love them. But after only 3 games of wearing shorts, the White Sox felt the joke was overplayed and never wore them again. However, these jerseys became notorious, so in 2016, the White Sox announced they would wear the jerseys again and give away free jerseys to fans as a promotion. Even though they were paired with baseball pants, pitcher Chris Sale found them extremely uncomfortable. He begged the White Sox to let the team wear their regular jerseys during his start, but they said no because they had already made thousands of them to give away to fans. This pissed off Chris Sale so bad, he went around the clubhouse with scissors and cut his and his teammates' jerseys hours before the game. Since the jerseys all had holes in them, the White Sox were forced to wear different jerseys and also suspended Chris Sale. But as mad as Chris Sale was, no pitcher was more mad than David Cone after this play. He was so angry, he started arguing with the ump, even though there were men on base. So while he was screaming at the umpire, another runner came in and scored. Cone got even angrier and kept screaming at the ump. Problem was, there was another runner on base who scored all the way from first base as Cone continued to scream at the ump. Nyjer Morkan got caught screaming at himself after he almost made this amazing catch, but for some reason, he thought he hit the ball over the fence. It didn't go over the fence. So while he slammed his glove and started yelling at himself, Adam Jones went all the way around the bases for an inside the park home run because Nyjer Morkan never picked up the ball. Tommy John probably should have been even angrier after he fielded this ball, made an error. The right fielder was about to throw the runner out until Tommy John cut the ball off for no reason, another error, then proceeded to throw the ball into the dugout, allowing a run to score, setting an MLB record with 3 errors in a single play. That sounds like the dumbest record of all time. It's actually not, because Lloyd Mosley set an MLB record by stealing the same base twice in one play. He was safe the first time, and when the catcher threw the ball into the outfield, he, for whatever reason, got confused and started sprinting the wrong way around the bases. They tried to throw him out again, and there was another throwing error. So he was able to go back to the base he had just stole seconds earlier. Javi Baez did something similar, and it actually worked. He started running backwards to avoid the tag. Problem was, there were 2 outs, and all the Pirates had to do was throw the ball to first to get out of the inning. But for some reason, they tried to throw it home, but still only had to throw the ball to first for the run not to count. Nobody was there. They threw it anyway, and Javi Baez was able to make it 2 seconds. These That's plays funny. Were dumb, but they didn't affect the outcome of the game tremendously. Plenty of dumb plays have. Like when the Giants hit a ball to right in the bottom of the 9th in a tie game. The outfielder missed it, meaning all the runner had to do was run around the bases and the Giants won. He went the wrong way, realized he went the wrong way, went the right way, missed the bag, then had to go back the wrong way to touch the bag, then tried to go to third anyway. Should have been out by a mile, but a bad throw allowed him to be safe. Then he tried to go home and was out by 20 feet. But no dumb mistake in history screwed a team over more than this one. In the 8th inning of a tie game in Game 7 of the World Series, Terry Pendleton hit a double which should have easily put the Braves up 1-0. However, Lonnie Smith got tricked by the second baseman who did this. Thought the ball might have been caught and stopped completely. Instead of scoring easily, he stopped at third. The Braves failed to score, and the game went into extras. No.
But that's a good fake, though.
Tied 0-0, meaning that this could have been the difference. The Twins ended up walking them off and won the World Series. But even this play doesn't come close to the dumbest ever. That award goes to this guy, who did the age-old trick of running onto the field during the game, despite knowing you're going to go to jail. Earlier this year, this guy attempted it so he could propose to his girlfriend. As he got on one knee, security destroyed him. This guy might have been the smartest to do it. He ran onto the field, juked security, jumped over the outfield wall, avoided another guard, climbed onto the batter's eye, and jumped out of the stadium without getting caught. This was an amazing display, but even he was reportedly arrested outside of the stadium shortly after. The dumbest offender was in Philly, the day after another fan became famous when he was tasered on the field while running on it. This became national news, sparked debate around the country, and increased security at Citizens Bank Park. Despite all of this negative attention, the very next night, another fan did it. He apparently ran onto the field, tried to run away, but got tired and gave up. As he walked off the field, he was booed and even heckled by Jason Worth. After the game, it was reported he was charged with defiant trespass, disorderly conduct, and possession.
Defiant.
Meaning, in all likelihood, like this guy ran like onto the field knowing he was going to get arrested, while also probably knowing he had illegal substances in his pocket. And it doesn't get much dumber than that.
I love sports. I love the fact that it's humans doing this, and sometimes the brain just shuts down. I've been playing soccer for the most football for the most part of my life, and I can tell you, I've been a referee too, and sometimes the brain isn't with you and you make the dumbest mistakes. But then again, shit happens. I like this one. I love this one. Let me know if you want me to carry on with different kinds of sport. We got baseball this time. Let me know if you want to check out, want me to check out anything that has to do with NFL, NHL, more MLB, whatever you want. Let me know in the comment section. And if you did enjoy this, smack the like and of course hit that subscribe. And this was the channel, Baseball Doesn't Exist channel. If you want to check it out, link for it is available in the description, as well as for this video we watched. Go there and give them the love and support that they so much deserve. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Recky. You, stay safe.